Freddie Davis here, president of Market Faith Ministries, coming to you once again from the library. Market Faith Ministries provides radical disciple training to help believers become more knowledgeable of and confident in their Christian faith. We are a lay seminary in a can. Today we're continuing our series on the seven worldview questions, and today we're up to number four, what happens to a person at death? Now, of course, every one of the worldviews has its own answers to each of the worldview questions as they try to describe their understanding of the nature of reality. Naturalism, for its part, believes that when death occurs, that the life form simply ceases to exist. There is nothing beyond that. In animism, we see that they believe that a person's spirit at that point enters the spirit side of reality. That while a human being, while on this earth, they are in a physical body, but once the body dies, then the spirit enters into the spiritual realm. In Far Eastern thought, they believe that the life force of the individual is reincarnated into another life form, and that continues to happen through the reincarnation process until they finally get to the place where they're able to escape the material realm. Now in theism, theists believe that once a person dies, the physical death, that they enter eternity either in heaven or hell. Now there is some variation among various theistic groups, but generally speaking, that is the way that they take things. Now as Christians, our authority source for understanding reality is God's revelation in the Bible. The Bible teaches that those who come to know Christ during their mortal life will spend eternity in heaven with Him, while those who don't will spend eternity separated from Him. If you'd like more information about the topic of worldview and its practical implications for the Christian life, I'd like to invite you to check out our website at www.marketfaith.org.